In this video, we're going to take the graph of a solution to a linear system in the phase plane, and we're going to draw corresponding x of t and y of t graphs in the x, t, y, t planes. So suppose we just have some kind of system here. Actually, not necessarily linear. This example will not be a linear system. And suppose we have a solution, x of t, y of t, with initial condition x 0, y 0 equals 2, 1. And let's say we're given its graph in the phase plane. So we have the x, y plane. And the graph of this solution will look like this. So we're going to start at the initial condition, at the initial point, 2 comma 1. And it's going to kind of wrap around like this. And then just keep spiraling until the spirals get really, really small and you can't see them anymore. So the question is, if you have a graph like this, how do you relate this information, the phase plane information, and how do you draw this solution as just a graph of x of t and y of t? So here we'll put an x of t graph and a y of t graph. And we'll try and translate this information into a picture over here. So what is it saying that we start at the point 1, 2? Sorry, 2, 1. Well, that means in the phase plane, our solution begins at this point. So it's at the point where x is 2 and y is 1. So at time t equals 0, x is 2. And y is 1. So we know where we're starting. And now we're just going to focus on what happens to the x coordinate as t increases. So the first thing that happens is once we turn on time, we start moving in this direction along the solution curve in the phase portrait. So we move in this direction, and the x coordinate increases from 2 to 3. So you can see as we move along this curve, the x coordinate increases from 2 to 3. And then at that point in time, the x-coordinate kind of levels off. So as we move up here, the x-coordinate stays roughly constant as we move forward in time. So we'll stay roughly constant for a while. Then our solution will be up here. And we see that what happens to the x-coordinate as we move along this solution is it's going to decrease from 3 back to around 1. So we're going to decrease from 3 back to around 1. And then after that happens, for the next chunk of time, we're going to be heading down here. So the x-coordinate is again staying roughly constant for a little bit. And then once we get here, the next thing that happens is we move along this curve to a little bit back past x equals 2. So we're just going to go a little bit past x equals 2. And then we stay constant for just a little bit, moving up. And then clearly what's going to happen is the x-coordinate is going to move back and forth. And we're going to hover in and settle around x equals 2. So eventually, it's just going to look kind of like this, where you can see we're kind of zeroing in on x equals 2. So one thing to notice about this is that I couldn't tell you exactly what time any of these events occurred. So if you're just looking at a phase portrait, a solution curve in the phase plane, you can't tell any time information. You know that the solution will go this way as time increases, but I can't tell you exactly when the solution is at a certain point in this guy without some additional information. So we could tell where we were at time t equals 0 because we had some additional information. So I knew we were at 2 when time equals 0 because we were told that over here. But just by looking at this picture, there's no time information in it. So you can see there's an x-axis and a y-axis. There's no t. So you can figure out what happens as events happening one after another, but I can't put any numbers on this t-axis. So this is the kind of information you can get. It's a little bit limited. So next, we want to do this for the y of t graph. And the other detail about the time information here is, you know, while I can't put numbers on the y of t graph, I can make sure that events that occur to the y coordinate occur at the correct times relative to events in the x coordinate. So I'll show you what I mean. So here we start at y equals 1, so y equals 1. Then for a little bit, we're just going to be moving to the right when you turn on time. So you're just going to be moving to the right, which means the y coordinate stays roughly constant. And that's going to happen for roughly the same amount of time that x spends increasing before it levels off. So we see x increased to 3 during this chunk of time. Well, y should stay constant during that chunk of time. So y is going to stay constant at 1 during that first little bit of time. But then y is going to suddenly turn upwards and move to 3. So in the next little chunk of time, y is going to move upwards and move to 3 while x is staying roughly constant. So y is going to jump upwards. This is just a very rough graph. While x is staying constant. Then during the next chunk of time, what happens? Well, the next chunk of time, we moved from here to here. Y stays roughly constant at 3 while x decreases. So while x is decreasing, y is going to stay roughly at 3. And we can proceed in this manner. So the next thing that happens is y goes down from 3 to 2. So that's going to take about that chunk of time. And then the next thing that happens is y stays constant for a little bit. So that's going to happen during this little chunk of time. And then, well, it's going to get harder and harder to be accurate as these get smaller and smaller. So this is going to end up leveling off around. It's going to oscillate. It's going to end up leveling off around y equals 2. As you can see, we'll be oscillating up and down in the y coordinate as we approach that point. So this is roughly what the graph should look like. And it doesn't have to be completely accurate. Sometimes it's easier if you actually superimpose the x of t and y of t graphs, so you don't have to line it up the way I did. But as you can see, there's relative time information. So you know where your x and y coordinates are doing certain things relative to one another. But I still can't put numbers on the t-axis to tell you exactly when these things happen. So this is sort of the difference between the phase portrait picture and the x of t and y of t picture. And this sort of problem and the reverse problem, where you take x of t and y of t graphs and see what you can understand about the phase portrait, are pretty revealing about what kind of information is contained in each of these presentations of a solution to a system.